The time is 1924. The man, Senator Oscar W. Underwood. Senator Underwood wanted very much to be President of the United States. He was a good man, with experience, integrity, honesty, and devotion to public service. But in 1924, an ugly bigotry smoked in the land. As the National Democratic Convention drew near, the Knights of the Ku Klux Klan burned crosses against Al Smith, the leading candidate for the presidency. Oscar W. Underwood of Alabama was convinced the Klan was contrary to all principles of democracy, but because he yearned for the presidency, he had to choose between personal ambition and principle. This was a test of political courage.
At this convention, we have a mission to perform,
which is quite apart from any political ambitions that I may have. Our mission is to see that the Democratic Party condemns the Ku Klux Klan and everything it represents. We have got to drag it out of the platform committee and onto the floor in full sight of every delegate. Now, a moment will come, ladies and gentlemen, in this convention, when every delegate will have to declare publicly whether he approves the Klan or not.
Oscar, two members from the Georgia delegation are out there waiting to see you.
What's the matter?
I don't know those two men, Oscar. But I can't help remembering that the Klan controls 85% of the Georgia delegation. Arithmetic doesn't have anything to do with morals or principles. So far, you've got about 230 votes you can count on. The next ballot, the Klan controls about 500 votes. You add those two figures together and you get a total. The nomination, if the only thing that matters, is the arithmetic.
Show them in.
Come in, gentlemen.
Evening, Senator.
Good evening, gentlemen. Come right in. Be seated, please. I will be frank, gentlemen. Governor Smith
has pledged his support to me if I can count the Georgia delegation in my column on the next ballot.
Senator, we're going to be very, very frank with you. McAdoo isn't going to make it, and he knows it, and we know it. And we're going to pull out from under McAdoo on the next ballot.
Well, we're in the swing vote your way, Senator.
We're not asking you to do something that we wouldn't be prepared to do ourselves. I think most people know your feelings about the Klan. I mean, you're on the record, Senator.
A very strong record it is, too, sir. Very strong. You stand against the Klan.
And standing against the Klan as I do, do you still feel that you can get me their votes?
Senator, whatever you think about the Klan, they are Christians willing to forgive and forget.
It's very Christian of them.
Oh, not that all of them feel that way, sir. Some of them are bitter, Senator. Very bitter. They say things like, we're gonna tromp Oscar Underwood into the ground.
That's just the hotheads among them.
But you see, Senator, we feel the more responsible members of the Klan would look in favor on your nomination if you would,
Yes?
If you would pledge yourself, so to speak, not to single them out in the election campaign. So if you could find forgiveness or tolerance in your heart, I'm sure the Klan could find the same.
After all, we all Americans, aren't we?
Well, I guess that's about it, Senator. I don't expect the next ballot to be the clincher, but the one after that will be, so. Well, you think it over, and we'll telephone you next hour or two during the battle, and you let us know.
You understand, Senator, we're not guaranteeing anything. Some of those hotheads just won't go along with you.
But like we said, the more responsible elements of the Klan are certainly willing to wait on your answer and take your word as a Southern gentleman of honor.
Thank you.
Votes, Oscar. You're up 33 1/3% over the last ballot. Davis is only up 31% now. The percentages hold. I believe in arithmetic. I believe what Homer Cummins told me about politics. The first function of a politician is to get himself elected. Everything else he does after that is a splendid redundancy. Sent Underwood Suite. This is Collins speaking. Yes? Gentlemen from the Georgia delegation calling. They're preparing for the 103rd ballot. Oscar. You want to talk to him? Just a moment, please. These people can be vindictive. They can ruin you in politics. That was no idle threat. They can tromp you into the ground.
I think I'll go out and get some fresh air. Let me know how the next ballot comes out.
The Senate has nothing to say to you. No, not now or ever.
Oscar W. Underwood paid a high price for his act of courage. He not only lost the Democratic presidential nomination, he also lost his renomination for the Senate. The year 1924 offered him his last chance for the presidency and his first chance for greatness. He chose greatness.